Welcome to Dallas, Texas. We're here for the 75th annual meeting of the Society of Vertebrate Paleontology here on the 14th of October 2015. My name is John Long. I'm the president of the Society of Vertebrate Paleontology, and we're here at the 75th annual meeting, the meeting where we love to get together and talk about our new discoveries, our breakthroughs, and of course to rekindle old friendships. And as we get together here with our colleagues to discuss the latest discoveries, it's time to reflect on another iconic image, the Society's logo. Who created it, and what are the symbols that it signifies? I'd like to introduce Matt Colbert.
My grandfather was a curator at the American Museum of Natural History in New York City, and my grandmother was a scientific illustrator who illustrated many of the books and fossils that he described. After the Society of Vertebrate Paleontology was established, they realized that it needed a logo to symbolize the society. And my grandfather brought back the task to my grandmother, who settled upon some elements that she thought were emblematic of the field as a whole.
Ned and Margaret lived in New Jersey with their sons. Margaret did her art on the back terrace. All the while, the children would be running around. She submitted several designs to Ned, and finally, one Sunday afternoon, working in the sun with a vicious cold, she came up with the design that is now the logo of the SVP.
It's such a simple logo. It's just the three vertebrae in the center, one of the neural spines, you know, neatly broken off, the marsh pick, symbolizing how you get those fossils, and then the circle to unify it all. So it's a very simple, very elegant logo, but it says so much about vertebrate paleontology, the vertebrae being the data that we use to study the fossils, right? The bones themselves, and the pick, which really symbolizes that you need to go out and find these things. And no matter how much technology advances and how we find new ways to collect data, the basis of paleontology is finding the fossils and going out and getting them. What really brought it home to me was when I found out that Margaret Colbert did it. To me, the fact that this art was put together by someone so intimately associated with paleontology also made a real statement to me.
This is Ned Colbert's original marsh pick. This was the one that was used as the model for the SVP logo. It's an iconic tool for vertebrate paleontology, in part because it's on our logo, but also because in the old days, people used these in the field. And it works well for the kind of work that we do. It's delicate enough that it doesn't do a lot of damage if you actually hit a bone.
The vertebra illustrated in the logo actually represent an extinct amphibian called Areops. And this was described by a famous paleontologist, Edward Drinker Cope, and was actually illustrated by Margaret Matthew's father, my great-grandfather, William Diller Matthew. Kind of all ties together in a family in that respect.
So Matthew, after joining the American Museum in 1895, rose rapidly through the ranks. By 1908, he was curator in charge. William Diller Matthew's daughter, Margaret Matthew, married Ned Colbert at the American Museum. And that was just a tremendously productive relationship, both in terms of their caring for each other as a family and their fruitful thinking about science together.
The elements in the logo also illustrate two famous characters in the history of vertebrate paleontology.
One of the things that's interesting to me about the SVP logo is that you have the Areops specimen described by Cope and the marsh pick superimposed. And Cope and Marsh are two famous people with respect to what's become known as the Bone Wars. Kind of went at each other in the literature and in person and in the field. Marsh was a leading paleontologist at Yale University, and Cope was based in Philadelphia. And both the East Coast was the center of vertebrate paleontology in the mid-1800s. When the western interior of the United States was opened up to exploration, both Cope and Marsh had field parties out in the West collecting fossils.
Edward Drinker Cope was the scion of a very wealthy family. He inherited what would be now in the tens of millions of dollars when his inheritance came through, and he used it all basically to build this collection, and he kept it in his house. And later in life, he ran into financial difficulties, and the American Museum of Natural History was able to purchase parts of the collection.
My name is Laura Hornbach, and my great-great-great-grandfather, Jacob Bull, discovered the Areops skull on the North Texas frontier on the Red River in 1876. He gave that skull to Edward Drinker Cope, who named it. Our family was part of the original Swiss colony here in Dallas, and Jacob was more comfortable speaking and writing in German.
Areops was part of a very important early Permian vertebrate community. The type specimen that Bull found was the skull, but he collected many other specimens. One that he shipped back to Cope, he wrote the address on a piece of brown paper as a label, and on the other side of it, he wrote a poem in his native German, an ode to Areops.
Nun wirst du mit noch manchen anderen zum Sitze des Professors wandern. Geistreich denkend wird dich erwecken, aus deinen Trümmern dich zusammensetzen. Der Nachwelt wird dann erzählen, wie du gebaut in deinen Zähnen, wie du gelebt und wie verschwunden, benennen dich und was gefunden.
Now you will, with some few others, trek to the professor's seat. Awaken through his careful thought, be reassembled from your fragments. To tell to others yet to come, from the sculpting of your teeth, how you lived and disappeared, name you he will, and what he found. I was 12 years old when I went on my first dig. My mother came along, and I found what I later would know was an Areops clavicle. At first, it was exciting to find my first bone. It looked like a tooth. It later became a rib. I got to jacket my own fossil and take it back to the museum. And then it was later discovered it was Areops, the iconic animal of the SVP logo.
One of the big efforts SVP is making is to be a lot more international. And one of the results of this is that now our iconic logo for SVP is now not so North American centric, but we have members from all over the world. So our symbol has moved all over the world as well.
I carried back this SVP logo to Japan, and even because I have these Mongolian students, I have many connections with other countries, so this logo distributed in many, many countries in different generations. For me, when I was a student, it was kind of a dream to come to SVP, and it's passed on to my students, and they're so excited to be here and meeting all the people. And they have more connections with other people from other countries.
Whenever I go out in the field, I always wear my SVP hat. It's a khaki hat, I always put it on, has the logo right on the front of it, Society of Vertebrate Paleontology. I'm always very proud to wear that. So I wear it in China, I've worn it in South Africa, I'll wear it again in South Africa this year, but I always take that with me.
Marsh and Cope are brought together in the SVP logo, the vertebrae described by Cope. Behind them, a marsh pick. The circle represents SVP unity. First used in May 1943, it has symbolized our society ever since.